There are a couple different methods for solving systems of three equations. The method that I'm going to be showing you today is called the backsolving method. Now, the wonderful thing about the backsolving method is that if you've already learned how to solve a system of two equations using the substitution and eliminations methods, it's going to be really easy for you to build on that knowledge to learn the backsolving method today. If you need a recap of those other two methods, I'll leave links to those tutorials in the description box below. Other than that, let's get started with today's math. In today's problem, we are going to try to solve for x, y, and z in this system of three equations here. Now, you may be wondering what exactly this system represents, since when we had a system of two equations with two variables, we knew that it represented two lines and we were looking for their intersection point if there was one. This is a very similar case. The only difference here is that instead of lines, we have planes, and these planes are in 3D space. And once again, we are looking for whether or not these planes intersect with each other. All right, so I've outlined the steps over here of what we're going to do. We're going to begin by picking two equations and eliminating a variable. So I'm going to look at the equations and I'm going to begin by picking the first and second equation, because when I look at those, I see that the minus z and plus z are going to be really easy to eliminate. We have the two equations copied down, and because minus z plus z equals zero, all I need to do to eliminate the z variable in this problem is add the two equations together. So that's the first equation that we're going to be working with, but I'm going to pause right there and just leave that equation as is for the moment. I'm going to move on to step two, which says pick a different two and eliminate the same variable. So I'm going to pick two different equations now and also eliminate the z variable from them. I am going to choose the first and the third equation this time, because once again, the minus z and plus z is going to be really easy to eliminate in this problem. Once again, all I need to do is add the two equations to eliminate z. Now I have two equations with two variables. And if you think back to what you know about systems of equations from algebra 1, 2, we know that it's really easy to solve this system of two equations using the elimination or substitution methods. So next I'm going to take these two equations and solve for one of the variables. I am going to choose to use the elimination method because I think it's going to be really nice to multiply this first equation by a negative 4 so that the x's will add away. So after I distribute this negative 4 through to all three of the terms, I get there we go, that's our first solution. So now we have found the answer to one of the variables, and we're going to begin that back solving process to find the solutions to the x and z variables. So the next thing I want to do is back solve with a two variable equation. So I have two options here. I have this two variable equation and this two variable equation. It doesn't matter which one I choose. I'm going to go ahead and use the first one, and I'm going to plug in 2 for y and solve for x. There we go. Now we know that x equals 1 and y equals 2. So we're going to do our final step and back solve one more time to find z. This time we will back solve with one of the original three variable equations. So those were these equations up here. And I can choose any of these equations that I want. Of course, I'm going to choose the easiest one here, the third one, which is x plus y plus z equals 4. I'm going to copy down that equation and plug in x equals 1 and y equals 2 for x and y, and we will solve for z. So in this problem, we found that the coordinate point that our three planes intersect at is 1, 2, 1. So you can write your solution as a point with the x variable first, the y variable second, and the z variable last. For our second problem, we're going to solve this system of equations here. And you'll notice that in this one, not all three of them have three variables. This first equation only has a y and z, and that's perfectly okay. We can still solve our problem, and actually it'll make things just a little bit easier for us. So just like in our last problem, we're going to start by picking two equations and eliminating a variable, and then picking another two equations and eliminating a variable. So that way we have two equations with two variables. So we can take a little bit of a shortcut here. Because we already have one equation that only has two variables in it, I can really skip this first step of choosing two equations and eliminating a variable because I already have an equation with a variable eliminated. Now for step two, I need to pick another two equations and eliminate the same variable. So because this equation is missing an x, I need to eliminate an x from the other two equations. So obviously, in order to do that, I'm going to need to choose the second and third equation and eliminate their x's. There are a couple options here. Of course, you could use the substitution method by solving for x. That would be one good option. Another option would be to use the elimination method and multiply this first equation by negative 3. So then I just copy down the second equation again underneath it, and I'm going to add these two equations together to eliminate a variable. So that is my second equation. So here are the two equations that I'm going to use to solve for either y or z. So step three is I'm going to take these two equations and put them together and solve using either elimination or substitution. I could do, again, substitution or elimination. I'm just going to stick with elimination. So I'm going to multiply this first equation by a positive 2. Now all I have to do is add the two equations together. And then, oh my, what do we have here? 0 equals 2. Well, that's no good, right? Because 0 does not equal 2. And when you get a scenario where all your variables drop out and you're left with an equation that doesn't make sense, that means that there is no solution. And when you're talking about systems of three equations, they introduce some new terminology. And so we would also say that this is an inconsistent system. That's all you can really do for this problem, so this would just be your answer. In this problem, we have three equations and three variables. Now, it may look a little bit different because none of the equations have all three variables in them, and that's completely okay. We're going to solve it exactly the same way that we have been using the backsolving method, and this time it's going to be a nice easy start since all of our equations already have two variables, so our first pick two is really easy. We only need one of the equations since a variable is already eliminated. I'm going to just take this first equation right here, x plus y equals 9, as my first pick two. Next, I am going to take the other two equations, and I want to eliminate the z variable since this equation doesn't have a z in it. Or in other words, this equation has an x and y, and so I want the equation I'm going to form out of these other two equations to only have an x and y. Now these equations are really fortunate for us because all we have to do is add them together for the z's to drop out. Because we have positive z and negative z, those are going to cancel out. So I'll just have y plus x, or if I want to rearrange that, I could say x plus y equals 7 plus 2, which is 9. So now I have the two equations that I'm going to use in step 3. So for step 3, remember, we want to solve those two equations using the substitution or elimination methods. Now, you'll already notice something interesting here. They are the exact same equation. In this sort of scenario, we would say that they are dependent because you could multiply one by a constant to get the other. In this case, that constant is simply 1, which makes it really obvious that they are dependent equations. Now, to eliminate the variables, I'm just going to subtract the 2. And when I do that, I see that all of the variables drop out. I'm left with simply 0 on the left side. And then on the right side, I have 9 minus 9, which is also 0. We have a true statement here. So unlike our second example where we had 0 equals 2, which was a false statement, this time we have 0 equals 0, which is a true statement. And that means that there are infinitely many solutions to this system of three equations. So we simply just say that this system has infinitely many solutions. Another thing to note is that this is a consistent system. Unlike our system in example 2, which was an inconsistent system. Any system that has one or more solutions is considered consistent. So the only scenario you would have an inconsistent system would be like that in example 2, where we had 0 equals 2, which was a false statement and there was no solution. As you can tell, these problems can get pretty tedious quickly. That's why next time I'm going to show you how to use matrices to simplify that math and solve systems of three equations. Till next time, I'm Brett, and thank you so much for watching.